everybody. Mike Tirana here, talking to you from the privacy of my secret man cave. And I want to talk to you guys about the double stroke roll. It's an important rudiment. You know, you use it a lot in the paradiddle. If you're going to do a five note grouping, these are all compound strokes, you know, singles and doubles. So if the left hand is not as strong as the right hand, I'm right-handed, so you're going to have problems to execute those rudiments properly. So what I want to do is I want to develop an exercise that allows me to gain control and have an equal balance and power with both hands. So here we have the drumstick. It's a very simple machine. First and foremost, I suggest that you get yourself a stick that you're comfortable with. For me, it's the Vic Firth Mike Tirana model, you can see. Not trying to sell you anything, it's just the stick that I used, and these are custom made for me. It's a modified SD4, I've done some videos on it before in the past. The most important thing when you find a stick is to make sure that it's not too top heavy, that it's not too back heavy, maybe it's not too small for your hand. If you have big hands, you want to feel that grip. You want it to be comfortable. And secondary is that you must find the balance point on the stick. That's extremely important for rudimental control. Okay? So if you hold the stick too close to the tip, you notice it doesn't bounce very good. Huh? You hold it too far back, also not bouncing very well. So what I've done is I've done some little tests, you know. Try to find the balance point. Grab the stick between thumb and forefinger. For me, it's the magical spot is right there on that H of the Vic Firth logo. Okay? You can see that the stick wants to bounce. And I'm not using my fingers, I'm just pinching the stick between my thumb and forefinger. So the stick is doing the work, and that's what we want. We want free rebound. Same with the left, okay? You can see the stick is using its own momentum, and I'm getting free strokes or free rebounds just by having the proper balance point. Now, another important tip is my sticks are a little bit slippery when they come from the factory. So I take something like surf wax. This is tropical surf wax, so it's a little bit sticky. And the surfers use this when the weather is humid. And of course, when you're playing drums, your hands are wet, you're in a club, or you're under hot lights, and you don't want to lose the stick. I don't like to lose the balance point, okay? If the balance point is moving around, then I'm losing my fulcrum and I'm losing control of the free bounces. So I found that by having a little bit of stickiness, you know, using this surf wax allows me not to have to grip the stick so hard, you know? The stick stays on my finger. It's not sliding. So I don't get any cramps in my hands. I'm not holding on and trying to control the stick. It's just a very relaxed, free movement. I'll move to the side so you can see that. You can see the stick just wants to bounce. So you should be able to do a double stroke roll just by pinching the stick between the thumb and forefinger. No fingers. See, I get one clean double. Now, what allows me to get a more powerful double to pull out that second stroke is using the fingers. Okay? Some people call that the free stroke. Some people call it a snap. I think it's more like a snap for me because when I throw the stick down, I pull up and I snap it up. And you notice that both notes are the same intensity and volume. And that's what you want when you do a double stroke roll. Okay? You don't want to hear You don't want that second note quiet. You want it to be even. So what I do is I use my fingers to pull out that second stroke. Very important for playing all the different rudiments and for moving the rudiments around on the drum set, which I'll show later in some other exercises. This video, I just wanted to concentrate on the technique of the double stroke. And now I'm going to show you the exercise that I created for myself. Of course, the best way to do it is with a metronome. And you don't have to play it really fast. We can start off at 120 BPM. You know, the most important thing is to play all the exercises slow in the beginning with a metronome, okay? You don't need to come out and start blasting away. The most important thing is to get that feeling and to look at any mistakes you might have and correct them as you're playing along. Okay, so now I'm just going to play the right and the left hand independently at 120 BPM. And you'll notice that both notes are even. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to alternate, okay? And this is the exercise that I use to clean up my doubles at 120 BPM. Okay, nice and slow, nice and relaxed. It's a great way to warm up. I do this before a show. You don't have to be burning and sweating, getting all crazy. The most important thing is to concentrate on the technique. So now I'll bump it up to about 100 and let me bump it up to about 160 BPM. This gets a little bit more challenging. Okay, same exercise. Okay, and if you'll notice, I'm doing the snap. There's some wrist involved and fingers to pick up the second note. And throw it down. And this is a great way to get speed without getting tired. Same for the left hand. Okay? So now we can play it a bit faster. You can go at about 200 BPM or more if you guys are blasting. Some of you blast beat guys out there, you go faster than that. 200 BPM, here we go. Okay, I'm sure there's guys out there that can play it faster, but most of the music I play, popular music, there's no reason to go much faster. There's a lot of guys out there playing extreme music and they need to do that, so this might be a good exercise for you. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more stuff. Here in my man cave, I'm working in my new studio and I'll be creating a lot more content for you guys in the future. Thanks again. Have a great day, practice hard, and I hope this helped you out. Cheers.